dynamical processes like the transcription of a gene can be mapped to sequential coin tosses. However, in doing so, we are discretizing time. But time is continuous, and discretization of time leads to error in our calculations. We have discussed this issue earlier while learning Poisson distribution. The solution is to make the discrete time intervals infinitesimally small. With del t tends to 0, the binomial distribution of coin toss becomes a Poisson distribution. The probability that k events will happen in an interval t is equal to mu to the power k divided by factorial k into e to the power minus mu. Here, mu is the mean number of events and is equal to lambda, the rate, into time. So in our simplified model, the probability distribution of the number of mRNAs produced in an interval follows the Poisson distribution. Many other dynamical processes have this property. All such processes are called Poisson processes. We will study the properties of Poisson processes. For that, we need some technical definitions. First, a counting process. Suppose there is a stochastic process with discrete events happening with time. We are counting how many such events have happened. This stochastic process will be called a counting process with count nt for t greater or equal to 0. Here count is non-negative, so nt should be always greater or equal to 0. It is an integer, so nt could be 0, 1, 2 and so on. And nt is non-decreasing. That means nt should be greater or equal to ns, where t is greater or equal to s. By ns I mean the count till time s, and nt is the count till time t. So nt minus ns is the count in the interval starting just after s up to t, including t. A Poisson process is a counting process with rate lambda such that the initial value of the count is 0. The events are independent, so the increment in the count is an independent increment. And the number of events happening in an interval follow Poisson distribution. Here the time interval is t from s to s plus t. When the rate lambda is independent of time, the Poisson process is called a homogeneous Poisson process. In this course, we will consider only time homogeneous Poisson processes. Let Tn be the time interval between the nth event and the n minus 1th event. We call Tn as the nth inter-arrival time. In a stochastic process, the time interval between two events is also a random variable. Now, what is the probability distribution of Tn, the nth inter-arrival time, for a Poisson process? To answer this question, we will calculate the probability distribution for T1, the first arrival time. Before T1, the count is 0. So, the probability that T1 is greater than an arbitrary time t must be equal to the probability that no events have happened by the time t. As this is a Poisson process with rate lambda, this probability is equal to the probability of happening 0 events in time t, that is lambda t to the power 0 divided by factorial 0 into e to the power minus lambda t. We can simplify this to e to the power minus lambda t. So, the probability that T1 is greater than T is equal to e to the power minus lambda T. Here is lambda is the rate of the process. Now we know the probability that T1 is less equal to T plus the probability that T1 is greater than T must be equal to 1. So, the probability that T1 is less equal to T is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus lambda T. By definition, The probability that T1 is less equal to T is the CDF of T1. And on the right hand side, we have 1 minus e to the power minus lambda T. This is the CDF of exponential distribution. So T1, the first inter-arrival time, must be following the exponential distribution with rate lambda. So the PDF of T1 is lambda into e to the power minus lambda T. Every event in a Poisson process is independent. So the second event is independent of the first one. Once the first event has happened, we can reset the clock to zero and wait for the second event. As we have reset the clock, now T2 is equivalent to T1. So just like T1, T2 should also follow the exponential distribution with rate lambda. So using the same logic, you can easily understand that this should be true for any other inter-arrival time. So in general, the inter-arrival time Tn of a Poisson process with rate lambda will follow the exponential distribution with parameter lambda. Now comes the waiting time. Waiting time is the time until a particular event. So the nth waiting time is the sum of all inter-arrival times till the nth event. So that is equal to T1 plus T2 up to Tn. Each of the inter-arrival time is an independent random number and they follow exponential distribution with parameter lambda. It can be shown that sum of n independent random variables following identical exponential distribution has the gamma distribution. So the PDF of waiting time for a Poisson process must be also the PDF of gamma distribution. Note that the gamma distribution has two parameters. For waiting time, those parameters are n, the event number, and lambda, the rate of the Poisson process. Following the gamma distribution, mean waiting time for a Poisson process is n divided by lambda, and the variance is n divided by lambda square. So here I jot down the key points. Poisson process is a stochastic process with discrete event happening in continuous time. In a Poisson process, the probability of having n events in an interval T follows the Poisson distribution with mean equal to lambda into T. The inter-arrival time, that is the time between two events in a Poisson process, follows exponential distribution. The parameter for this distribution is the rate of the Poisson process. Finally, the waiting time to observe the nth event in a Poisson process follow gamma distribution. N and lambda are the parameters. That's all for this video. Thank you for learning with me.